Beauty begins the moment you decide to be yourself. Infobooth 19. Today we are going to see one breakfast or dinner recipe, which is appam. It is simple appam I'm going to show with detailed step. So appam can be prepared in multiple ways, with yeast, without yeast, and you can add coconut milk and prepare, and so many varieties are there. So in this recipe I will show you just the plain appam. We are not going to use any yeast or anything. We are just going to ferment it overnight, and we are going to make an yummy appam which will be very crispy on outside and very soft on inside. With appam you can serve with coconut milk, which is a very traditional combination, I would say. It is very very tasty, sweet coconut milk. Or if you don't like to have it sweet, then you can have it with some spicy veg kurma, or you can have with non-veg gravies like chicken gravy, egg kurma. Any spicing would go well. With to start with, I have taken 1 cup of idli rice. So idli rice, how you need to select this, it should be little bit fat, then only for fermentation it will be very good and the batter will be very soft. So whatever cup you're taking, in the same cup you can measure. So for 1 cup idli rice, you have to take 1 cup of raw rice, which is regular rice we can take. So 1 cup idli rice and 1 cup raw rice. Along with that, 1/4 cup whole urad dal you need to take. So either 1/4 cup or little bit lesser than that. So in this recipe, urad dal will be very little only you need to add. So now what you need to do is like wash it nicely with 2 to 3 times with water, and then we are going to add 1 tablespoon of fenugreek seeds or methi seeds. So this will give more softness to the batter. So you can add 1 tablespoon of it, and then you just add some water and you have to soak it for around 1.5 to 2 hours. So minimum 2 hours is required. So up to 3 to 4 hours you can soak it. Now the rice had been soaked well. So now what we are going to do is we are going to add 3 to 4 tablespoons of cooked rice. So why we are adding this cooked rice? It gives more softness and it helps in proper fermentation. After adding this, we are going to grind it well to a fine smooth paste consistency. So either you can use it in a mixer or you can use it in a grinder. If you are using in a mixer, the only thing which you need to do is ensure that your batter should not get hot. When it is becoming hot, try to add some chill water or cold water you can add, and so that you can maintain the temperature throughout. In case if it becomes hot, the batter will not rise properly and appam will not come very fluffy. So if you are preparing it in grinder, that problem will not be there. So it will be in the speed level, you can set it to 15 to 20 minutes, and after 20 minutes if you see this much soft consistency we need for perfect. So now it's ready. I have transferred everything into one bowl. Now only you can add salt, because salt after fermentation, if you add salt, then the air formation will go off if we keep mixing more. So that's the reason we are adding salt at the beginning itself and we are mixing. I have added here rock salt. You need to mix it with hand, then only the heat from hand will help in fermentation. Mix it nicely and we close the lid and keep it for around 6 to 8 hours for fermentation. Night if you mix and keep, then morning it will be ready. Now if you see, after 8 hours the batter has risen well. It has become double in size. I'll show you how much it has got fermented. See how fluffy the batter had come. So this indicates that we are going to get the perfect appam in another 10 to 15 minutes. We are ready to go. So the appam, how much air formation is there? This is going to give the smoothness to the batter. In case if you have prepared more volume, only how much ever you need, you can transfer into different bowl, and then you can add water and you can bring it to the thin batter consistency. I'll show you how much water you need to add. So this much consistency we need to get it by adding water. Either you can add water and you can mix it and bring it to the batter consistency, or instead of water you can just add coconut milk also. That will give more enhanced taste. So that is called Thenga Pal Appam, which is coconut milk appam. So that at some other day I will just post that recipe. For here I am just making a simple plain appam for beginners, so that's the reason I am not adding any coconut milk to it. So now this is that appachetti or appam pan which we are going to use it for preparation. So you will get it in different material, either stone pan, iron kadai or non-stick, anyway, even stainless steel also we are getting it. Just keep it on the stove and heat the appam pan. So once it is hot, you can just take one ladle of it and you can pour it. Immediately after pouring, you need to rotate it and you need to spread. So how much ever thickness, appam generally it will be crispy on the outside and in middle it will be softer. So how much ever thin you want, you can just rotate it to that consistency. Our batter, we can say it has perfectly fermented, because as soon as you pour this batter, if you see lot of holes appearing, that means the batter is perfect. So close the lid and cook. Now if you see sides and all, it became golden brown. So that's where our appam is ready. You should not turn and put it. You should not flip it here. So that's all. It is ready. I'll show you one more like how to make. Immediately after pouring, quickly you need to do it. Otherwise it will start getting cooked and it will not be spreading easily. It won't take much time. Only the first one will take much time. Other than that, in 30 to 40 seconds, it will be ready. If you see how much crispy it has become. So you can have appam, as I told already, you can have it with coconut milk or any spicy gravy. Here I have taken coconut milk. I have mixed the first milk and the second milk and I have added some more water and I have just heated in stove. Coconut milk, you should not heat it for a longer time. Just you heat it so that it will be warm. Then I have added sugar and then this elaichi powder. So in some other video, I will just put how to prepare this coconut milk for appam and idiyappam recipes. Surely you all need to give it a try. It is a very, very tasty, yummy recipe. If you like my video, subscribe to my YouTube channel and share with your friends and family. If you try this recipe, share the dish photo to the email ID given below. Always be happy, stay positive, and spread the positivity to everybody. Thanks for watching.